Hey guys, it's me, Margaret, here with another part of Let's Play Sims 3 Into the Future. And today, I'm starting this episode a little bit differently because this notification popped right in the center of the screen and saying that it is Nick's birthday today, so we have something to look forward to today, as well as going to the utopian future. Ooh, I just forgot to turn off my air conditioner. How professional. I'll be right back. Alright, it is off now, and it seems that Stella just woke up. Okay, let me just get to do some things. Okay, so Spark is she went ahead and started cleaning stuff. I'm going to have Stella here use the bathroom and then take a bath, and you know, Nick woke up too. He can go ahead and use the bathroom, and might as well take a bath as well. They don't really take baths much, especially not in the future. They just get cleansed by some rays and stuff, and this aura of light, I guess. I don't know. Basically, what happens. okay, Spark is also gonna make his bed as well. That's nice. So, that's something new. They're taking baths today. Not that they're dirty or anything, but, you know, it's a rare sighting. It really is. Alright. She wants to be admitted for instability. I think we might do that because it could lead to something very, very bad. So, we'll have her go and do that really early in the morning. So the hospital is not too far away, which is good. So go ahead and be admitted for instability. And let's go to Nick, because I want him to actually go ahead and upgrade the trait chip slot so I can put in the cooking thing for Spark. We won't need it in the future, but for today and maybe a little bit later when we change the utopian back into the present, I want to have that option available that, like, you know, Spark will be able to cook for the family. You know, Nick and Stella so far. Maybe like Stella's husband. Whoa, he just knocked her out. What was that? Oh, wow, that's awesome. Creation. So now she is decent, still level 5. Okay, well, whatever. That's cool. Let's have him adjust trait chip slots. And awesome. Stella just got admitted for instability, so we'll have her go home afterwards. Alright, and then Nick, kind of sad to adjust trait chip slots, but you know, whatever. Alright. It's like, yeah, okay. He didn't have to knock her out this time. Okay, let's place in Steel Chef right there. Awesome. So now she has competent cleaner, robo nanny for any kids, AI angler for fishing, you know, if she wants to fish, handy bot to fix stuff, and Steel Chef to cook. So, that's awesome. Oh, hello. Alright, so let's have Spark here. Let's have her actually go to the kitchen. Use this awesome kitchen and serve lunch. Let's have her serve some... let's do porcini risotto because that sounds good. Look at him jogging. He's so cute. I don't know. Simbots or Plumbots are so cute. Let's have him sit over here and wait for the meal to be prepared. Not saying that these humans and these Sims are, like, lazy or anything, but, I mean, they really are, so. I mean, but he did build this, Simbot, so it's like a creation. And if he created it and not just bought it, you know, it means more. So, yeah. Anyway. That's my little, spiel. Not really spiel, just story. Alright, let's have her cook here. Hey, you wait for your meal. Yes, you sit there on that red bar stool. Sit. Alright. This is so cool. I love this kitchen. It's beautiful. Alright, let's just wait for her to hurry up. Oh my god, no! You put those hot dogs away! No, what is this? And stop it right now! He cooked hot dogs yesterday and they turned out terribly, as you could see. Put those away over here. Alright, what's this? Wait, she's cooking again? Continue cooking what? No, stop cooking. Oh, because she sees the Sims are hungry, so she's cooking for them. No, don't do that. It's okay. Oh well, whatever. Alright, so let's do that. And then afterwards, she's cooking something else. Looks nice. Alright, yes, you clean that up. Good, Stella will clean that up. And then I'll have Nick clean up after himself as well. And he could also clean up that since it is his mess. Oh, she baked cookies! Aww, so sweet. Okay, let's put away these leftovers because we don't really need them now. And I don't want to kind of waste food. It's kind of rude. You know, we're not in the future, so it's not like a food synthesizer. So let's have her go ahead and recharge. She's jogging around or running around today. Anyway, what I wanted her to do... Actually, don't recharge. I remembered. I did want her I wanted Stella and everyone else to kind of not get a job, but to, what is Nick going to do? Okay, nothing really spectacular. But I wanted them to go into the utopian future. And the thing was within the utopian future, once you go in, if you go into the utopian future right after the dystopian future, there is a great chance that you get meteor showers and some of the buildings are still dirty. And I did go in there before I recorded this episode, like 2 hours ago, but I didn't save. I see that, yes, there was still a meteor shower. I just wanted to test out if it was if it happens to everyone. And it seems like it did, because one of you guys, also amazing guys, commented below and told me about that and that should go to present first. But I didn't want to, like, do all the stuff for present and, like, spoil it for myself and, like, record a video without my initial reactions. If that made any sense, I hope I explained myself well. I hope I explained myself well. But basically, I just wanted to go show what I want to do is just show off the utopian future and then quickly leave, like, the next day and then go do the present stuff to change it. No, go to do the normal future stuff to change it back into the normal future to Oasis Landing normal style, I guess. And then after that, Stella will receive her lifetime wish and then she will be gifted that time traveler statue. It'll be awesome. And then after that, we could choose which, like, what place we want to live in. I'm going to do utopian place, the utopian future, because it's awesome. You guys will see it in just a second if you haven't seen it before. It's beautiful. It's one of my favorites because I'm such a girl. I'm such a girly girl too. So it's just amazing. And yeah, we haven't really had time to, like, explore it in this day that we're going to be doing right now. So I think the next time we'll come back. And yeah, hopefully I made sense there. If I didn't, oops. Okay, well, I will cut back when the screen is finished loading, which is actually, I think, is very soon, so I might not have to cut. Okay, I'll cut back. Alright, we have landed in the utopian future. You can see the rainbow load, and it's awesome. The first thing that they ask us to do is choose a home lot. You could either do, you know, the Oasis Landing Community Center, or you could do the lots that you purchased, and the lots that we purchased was the Auspicious Atoll, you know, that beautiful mansion kind of thing. It's beautiful. So we're gonna go there. Oh, you can see the different colored trees. Oh, it's beautiful. Wait for the families to load in. There they are. Back in the house. Look at them. They gotta teleport here in just a second because they get out of the portal first and then they teleport to the home lot. So, yeah, I just zoomed out for some reason. Oh, okay. Oh, there they are. Awesome. And Stella Cooper, some of your descendants have been located to blah, 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 blah. And I think the descendants live in the exact same place that they lived before. Yes, it's so unfortunate that they don't move. Like, we bought a great, beautiful house, an expensive house in the future, an expensive house in the present, and the descendants still live in this wasteland dump. It's literally a one bedroom, and there's, like, so many people living over here. Oh my god, I can't. And then Nick's descendants, let's see, they probably live the same place as well. I don't think they move, actually. I wish they did, but they live in, like, a semi, like, a wealthy neighborhood, like, wealthier than the wasteland. Yeah, it's like the middle class, I guess you can call it. Yeah, basically it is the middle class. So they live right here still in this four bedroom. So they're doing way better than Stella's descendants, but still not the best. You know, not as well as I hoped it would be since, you know, their family fonts have gone up extremely. So Stella, actually the first thing that she wanted to do is to go over here, but I just want to explore the area a little bit. I wanted Nick to get the mail since we have mail here, so go ahead and get that mail. And Stella, I noticed while I explore this town is that the water is beautiful. It's super bright blue. There's still some, you know, even though the trees are like purple and blue and these pink colors as you can see over there and lavender, just beautiful trees. They're just gorgeous. They still have like leaves, autumn colored leaves falling on the floor. So, I mean, the Sims can't be perfect, you know. So yeah, it's still autumn cobbled, but at least it's fall and it makes sense. It's still leaves on the ground, even though you, yeah, I mean, I don't see that these trees would drop leaves since they still look like they have a lot of leaves on them, obviously, as you can see right there. But I mean, oh well, whatever. Anyway, what else did I notice? I noticed that if I went a little bit over here, wait, hold on, where's the house? Okay. I moved my mouse a little bit towards over here. and I noticed this gigantic flower, and I saw that there's a couple of these around town, and basically when you shake them, I wanted to shake like it two times, but nothing really extraordinary happened. The only thing that happened was really that okay, nothing happened that time. Really? Oh, come on. Shake it. Shake it again. but oh, Nick received companion ignite. Yeah, she just gets some rain falling on her. Oh, okay, she gets a little refreshed. The last two times that I did, she got soaked. So either it's a oh, you could collect dew. Oh, that's awesome. Oh, that's great. Maybe this is the happiness dew. What's this? Yeah, use dew on someone. So let's see. She has does she still have the black dew? Yeah, it's the same thing, correct? Yeah, she just collected a dew. So either you shake them and you get soaked, or you shake them and you get some dew. So that looks like some dew, and we can just oh, we can't collect it anymore. We can shake it a little bit. I don't know. It doesn't look like it's improving her mood at all. So, okay, well, whatever. I guess we collected all the dew from that flower. But there's a lot of them around town here. There's a beautiful blue one. And there's like, oh my god, there's caterpillars on the floor. And there's butterflies flying around everywhere. So I really do love the Utopian Society because it is the perfect society. And this is how, you know, people imagine it to be. Just nice and calm. Peace and love and everything of that sort. Alright, but as you could see, the buildings are still filthy, some of them. Some of them are nice and beautiful like this one, but then others are just ugly like this one. And that's because you're going from dystopian to utopian. It's probably just a bug, so I'm gonna fix it later on. I hope, like, well, yeah, we're gonna leave tomorrow. We're just gonna stay one day here, maybe do something, like, I don't know, level up some skills or, you know, that sort of stuff. But let's see what we could do. Advanced Technology 8. Whoa, she's so close to leveling that up. That's crazy. Okay, but I do remember that she got something new that she was able to do. So program new recipe, the synthesized status cue surprise, do that. And then, sorry, he's taking a shower. Okay, he's cleansing himself. All right, that's perfectly fine. So go upstairs. And by the way, this water is so much better than the green, nasty, dirty water that we had before. Okay. Let's have him actually design the trait chip. I believe he's able to do that again. I'm not sure. We'll have to see. So now she is advanced. She is on the advanced technology skill level 9. Stella Cooper's knowledge of advanced technology has granted her improved sonic shower to power cleanse. Okay, well, we've done that already, actually. Okay, anyway, an additional dream pod dream. So she almost has all the dreams, I guess. We got a lot of stuff that Nick has. So let me sell all that stuff. So we got this thing for 1,156. And then we got this other thing from 623 smooths. Awesome. She's still programming it. All right. I'm going to go upstairs to Nick here. And once he becomes bot building level 10, I will have him... I will definitely go and explore, like, the bot competition. I'll have him dress up as a robot since he's, what do you call it? A bot fan. That's his trait, so he can turn into robot form anytime he wants, really. And, yeah, we'll do that. Oh, he just built the capacity to love a trait chip. Good for him. But anyway, what I was saying, before I got interrupted by myself, I will have him go and do that bot competition. So congratulations, you have programmed the food synthesizer to make a new recipe. Status cue surprise. Great, 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 great. Okay. She is still attracting space objects. She really, really loves to do this. Oh, by the way, what I didn't get to do also in the present, I will find her love, of course, because we never really got to do that. We met people, but we never really, got to know them. So she knows a lot of future residents and a lot of present residents. It's cool. Very, very nice. All right. We also need to get to know Emmett a little bit better. Oh, bless you, girl, bless you. I will have Stella, though. What can you do? What can you do? Stargazer, all you need is mood for that. Advanced technology, what else can you do, really? Nope, that's good. I guess you could just jetpack, start using jetpack. Let's just fly around a little bit. Let's go over here. Ah, he just built a solar-powered trade ship, so basically powered by the sun, so you don't have to tune them up, I'm guessing. I really am guessing. All right, let's go ahead and have her actually jetpack, fly around. Just keep on doing that. Do it and do it and do it until you can't do it anymore, basically. All right, hold on. My stuffy nose is coming back. Oh my god, it sucks. It really, really does suck. I'm getting sick, guys. I feel it. I do feel it. Okay, go ahead and fly around. Yeah, that's it. Okay, great. So she will be busy doing that, having fun here. It really is beautiful how the sun sets. Ugh, I love this utopian place. It's just, it's so gorgeous. With the exception of, you know, the few dirty buildings, but we can forget that. Oh my god, I love the color of the trees. I can't. I just can't. It's so saturated and colorful, and oh my god, it's literally yellow. The sky is literally yellow, and here it's like pink and purple. Okay, I need to stop being myself right now. Okay, Spark is just hanging out. I think we could have her actually rake a little bit more. I think that'll be very beneficial for her to do that. Alright, she wants to collect 3 curious dudes. Ooh, and visit the wasteland. Interesting. Equip the hollow projector trait chip. Oh, interesting. Well, I see that Nick has gotten a little busy with the hollow computer. Let's put it back where it belongs. And let's have him go ahead and design 2 more trait chips. And let's, okay, we didn't do that one. That was a failure. Okay, let's see if we can design this one. Let's see. It's getting a little bit late. They're going to have to eat, but... Oh, the sun set really early. Oh, that sucks. It's only 5 o'clock. Ugh, ew. Anyway, he discovered how to build a robotany gardener trait chip. Awesome. Design some more. Maybe we could even design a third one today. Let's see. Oh, he cannot. He discovered all the trait chip schematics that could be designed at the current bot building level. Okay, so let's have him actually... Let's see. Let's lock this want in. So let's see, he wanted to do that for a long time. What's this? Oh yeah, the thing that she wanted to do. What does she want? Oh, she wants to read inscription on a statue. Oh my god, I need to sneeze. Wait, no I don't. Wait, no I do. Oh my god, awkward pause in the video. Okay, anyway. alright, so I don't think we're gonna do any of that. Sorry, Stella. Okay, let's go ahead and design nanites then. Design 2 nanites, at least. Hopefully. Let's see how many we can do. Alright, Nick Cooper has discovered all the nanites that can be found. Yada yada yada. Okay, well whatever. So, well, let's see on level 7. Let's try to get him up to level 8. See if he can design some more trait chips and stuff of that sort. So, let's have him actually serve dinner. And let's have him serve synthesized stuffed turkey. That sounds good. Oh, she wants to change the future world. We will definitely do that. Lock that in. Definitely. Okay, enough flying around. Go back in here. Oh my god, gross! That's nasty. Okay, well, grab a plate. Sally, you could also grab a plate. Oh, bad quality. Ooh, don't grab a plate. Don't grab a plate. Oops, stop. Stop it, stop. Stop, stop. Stop. Okay, clean up and then clean that up too. So, a little machine malfunctioned, but oh well. Let's serve dinner, then let's do something else. Since I guess it's a sign that we shouldn't have, Turkey will have synthesized tri-tip tofu steak. No, let's just have tri-tip steak. Yeah, let's do that. Again? What is the matter? Oh my god, Nick. What is going on today? Oh my god, let's serve dinner again. Let's see if serving works. You wanted to have like hot wings before, so have some hot wings. Is that working? Pancakes. Oh, I see who decides what meal we eat now. Okay, yeah, I see. It really is. Oh, why is that doing that? Is it because Spark has a trait chip? Or is it just random? Because that doesn't seem very random to me. But I guess he decides what we eat and when we eat. Okay, fine. Breakfast for dinner. If you want to classify pancakes as a breakfast meal, of course. But, you know. Alright, Sims are very happy. And now they will go and go to bed. Go and do nothing at all. But go to bed. And of course, use the bathroom. So go use the bathroom and then go to bed. And Stella, you can just head back to sleep or head to sleep. And I think that is where I'm going to leave off this episode. It has been fun. I just want her to clean up a little bit. Okay, Stella, can that be awesome too? So clean up that too, since we don't have a fridge to store it in. We don't need it anyway. So it's very interesting how I see that Spark really decides the meals now and everything. So that's very, very, very cool. Alright, so yeah, like I was saying, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to believe in yourself. I love you guys, and I will see you guys very soon. Game on, and goodbye.